Welcome back to Let's Play Policenauts Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari and I'm walking away from the CD shelf. There was one in there that just played some kind of weird sound, so I'm thinking it's a data disc or some kind of audio clue or something like that. So I'm gonna finish looking at the stuff in the room and then talk to Karen, I believe her name is, so who's also the one we've been seeing on the news segments, who's a dead ringer for Lorraine, which is funny because Jonathan doesn't say anything about that. It's that when... Yeah, isn't that strange? Jonathan doesn't say, oh, she looked... I think he might have said she looked so familiar, but for some reason he couldn't place it, I guess? I don't remember him saying anything, oh, it looks like Lorraine. It's everyone else when we show, you know, them... The photo of Jonathan and Lorraine back from 25 years ago, they're like, oh, is that Karen, the news anchor? Like, no, no, it's Lorraine. Well, we'll say never mind, it's an old friend. Mom liked these. Okay, so I think we already looked at that. Ed says, that's an antique lamp. Twin lamps, I should say. They're connected to the sleep sensors in the sofas, Karen says. They also have chaos systems, so their lighting changes depending on who's in the room. So this is our color, Jonathan says. Yes, they give off ambient light, even during the day. They're cute, don't you think? Karen says. Is this anything? Stairs or something? Okay, look at that. That's one of Mom's flower vases. She did a lot of flower arranging. Lorraine always did like flowers, Jonathan says. Ed says, that's a zero-gravity ceramic, is it? That's unusual for Beyond. Right, it's porcelain. Mom probably ordered it from home. Flowers and plants reminded her of home, I'm sure. Mom liked it a lot. Is this a photo here? What is that? That's a picture of Mom. Dad puts pictures of her up everywhere. Jonathan says he has one in his lab at work, come to think of it. Dad put it there. Sofa? Love seat? Whatever. Ed says, looks like a comfortable sofa. Nice color, too. It's one of those chaos sofas. Its firmness and texture change depending on who's sitting on it. It has built-in sleep sensors as well, of course. Johnson says, chaos again. Ed says, built-in sleep sensors. Well, I'll be. Feel free to take a seat if you want, Karen says. Not getting that option. Thanks anyway, Karen. Say the same for all this. Ed says it's a marble table. I've never seen anything like this on Beyond before. It's an import from home, Karen says. The only problem is it doesn't really go with the sofas. Oh, jeez. First Beyond home... Beyond whatever problems. Take a look at this. Ooh. What's this? Jonathan asks. Ed says it's a biosphere. It serves as a model of the CLAS. CLAS stands for Closed Ecological Life Support System. You don't need to supply it with any food or oxygen. It's totally self-sufficient. Karen says, like this model, if the colony's balance were disturbed, it would become unable to support life. Huh. That's seaweed, Karen says. The seaweed uses the carbon dioxide, inorganic compounds, and sunlight to carry out photosynthesis. That water is filled with a bacteria soup. The temperature is maintained at 25 degrees Celsius. The bacteria oxidize the inorganic waste, producing carbon dioxide and inorganic compounds. Hmm. That's a coral fragment. Anything else to look at in here? Those are baby shrimp. Jonathan says they're mates, are they? She says the shrimp receive nourishment and oxygen from the seaweed and in return produce carbon dioxide and organic waste. That's interesting. Like actual working operating model of this whole self-sufficient ecosystem. Alright, what about this TV here? Ed says it's a wall-mounted plasma HD TV. It's got a chaos system, too. You can set the hue to change according to how you're feeling. Like if you're laughing or crying, for instance. Jonathan says, seems like everything's chaos. I remember things heading this way in the 20th when they brought out washing machines and ovens with neural networks and fuzzy logic and so on. Karen says, you're welcome to turn on the TV. Oh, we can actually do that. So is this down here the same thing? Okay, we'll watch a little TV. We're almost done in this room, and we're just gonna talk to her. Get to watch her.
こんにちは、ニュースオーダーの時間です。ビヨンド建設記念日を間近に控えた今日、地球へ回廊運動の決起集会が行われました。集会には約1万人以上のリーペイトリエイティストらが徳川ビル前に集まり、BCP の間に衝突もありましたが、怪我人は出ておりません。BCP では建設記念日に向けてテロ活動への警戒を呼びかけています。以上、カレン・ホージョーがお伝えしました。
これ、録画ですか？
いいえ、CG 合成です。私のデータからコンピュータが作り出した本物そっくりの映像です。
Really?So was she just talking to a microphone and then they animate her face? Let's see if we get anything else.
Beyond Coast 誕生30周年記念の催し物が各地で行われている中、Beyond の老朽化が深刻化しています。中でもミラーの老朽化が特に進んでおり、就航率の低下が危惧され、早急に対策が必要とされています。これに対し、宇宙推進事業団では10年計画でコロニー内の全パーツを取り替える方針を検討しているとのことです。以上、カレン・ホージョーがお伝えしました。
Have we seen that one already?Ed says, I'm going to try looking closer next time. Alright, let's try one more, see if we get anything new. Because I'm not sure about that last one.
繰り返します。今、全世界的に移植用臓器が不足しています。宇宙開発における宇宙環境の影響により、人体への様々な障害が起こっています。無重力状態や宇宙船などにより臓器の疾患、異常が急増しており、このままでは十分な移植が賄えないと、ドナー不足に対する大きな不安が寄せられています。宇宙推進事業団では、ホームの移植後進国などにドナーネットワークへの加入を呼びかけています。以上、BBC からお伝えしました。
I'm pretty sure we heard that one. It says, you'd never know that isn't really you. Well, the way it is her. How about this, dresser? Whatever? That's a makeup stand. Mom gave it to me when I turned 20. In Japanese culture, you're considered an adult when you reach 20. The mirror that used to go on top is broken, though. Now I just use it for the drawers. I thought it was a lot younger.Looked at everything. I think so in the room. We can look at stuff on her, like this bracelet. What are those? Jonathan says. These are medical bracelets. Ed asks, is this a serious problem you have? I'm afraid so. You're having problems with your health? You can say that, yeah. These bracelets have come into style lately, Karen says. What's this? What's that you've got there? Ed asks. This? My cell phone. You news anchors are pretty busy, huh? That's not the main reason I have it, actually. Jonathan says that Karen's wearing her cell phone on her hip. Belt buckle? Ed says, this is the first time I've seen you in anything low-cut, Karen. You always cover up on TV. Yes, it is a news program, after all. It's the station's policy. News order isn't some raunchy soap opera. I like to wear something more casual at home. I had no idea. About what? That you were concealing such considerable assets. Oh god, these are Jonathan's lines. She's speechless. So, do you choose your outfits yourself, Karen? Almost all the clothes I wear on camera are CG. Your clothes are CG? Well, I'm not naked during filming, of course. I do wear something. They alter it with CG in real time. So that's why you always seem to change so fast. They also make slight adjustments to the colors of my clothing depending on my condition in the day's news. Wow. I didn't know they did things like that. My makeup is done with CG as well. You'll have to excuse my appearance. I just got up before you arrived. Are you feeling all right? Ed asks. Yeah, don't worry about me. That's right, she... I think she's gonna need an organ. She's gonna need an organ donor. Alright, what else? Because you can talk about various things. Our hair? Jonathan says, your hair looks like your mother's when we first met. Ed says, your hair is even more vibrant off-camera. Keeping long hair is hard work in space. Yeah, I haven't seen many women with long hair here, Jonathan says. Ed says, it explodes under weightlessness. People say it's my most attractive feature, so the station kind of insists I keep it long. There's even an insurance policy on it. Now I've heard of everything, Jonathan says. Must be very high maintenance, says Ed. What about the earring? Oh, if we go to her chest, they're going to say something else, I bet. Ed says, Karen, you seem... how should I put it? Different in person than on TV. You're just as charming, of course. Maybe it's the CG? It's to cover up my complexion. Are you sick right now? Ed says. Actually, my problem is more than temporary. Jonathan says, it totally feels like I'm back with Lorraine. Alright, if we go here, we know they're gonna say something. Jonathan, probably. Although Ed, yeah, just... okay. Ed says, it's an honor to meet you in person like this, camera. Karen. I'm used to being looked at through a camera, but I feel kind of embarrassed when people stare at me in person. Alright. I guess we can talk to her now. Okay. Never mind. It's just her face. They use CG makeup on me when I'm on camera. Do I seem that different? Ed says, no, you're even more beautiful in real life. Ed, you're a lot older than her. The camera doesn't do you justice. Karen, you look just like your mother when she was your age. Tell me about it, Jonathan says. Well, I am her daughter. Alright, let's talk. Is it alright if we ask you a few questions? Ed asks. What is it? Okay. So we can only show a few things because our stuff has been analyzed and put away. Ask her about her parents. Ed says, this can't be an easy thing to talk about, but it is necessary for our investigation. What can you tell us about your parents? My father is a terrestrial who immigrated to Beyond shortly after it was completed. Jonathan says, your mother told me they met at Tokugawa's festival for Japanese people. Yes, that's correct. He said Mom was inconsolable after your accident. Lorraine, Jonathan says. He devoted himself to her, Karen says. They married 6 months later. Mom couldn't let go of you. The stronger Dad's love got, the more his jealousy grew. That's when their relationship turned sour. Mom still kept all the pictures she had of you. One day, Dad found them and burned every last one. She had no pictures of you after that. What about the one she carried with her? Didn't she have one? Well, that was our photo. They argued constantly, but they stayed together for my sake. That's a real Japanese thing to do. Honestly, I didn't really understand them myself. What does your father do at Tokugawa Pharmaceuticals? Ed says. All I know is he's involved with developing new pharmaceuticals. To your understanding, what kind of work is it? I don't know. He never much talked about it. He never discussed his work at home? Not with me, anyway. Hojo's job. Did he say anything you think might help us? Well, one time, I can't remember when exactly, he broke down in tears saying he wanted to quit Tokugawa. He said they lied to me. I hate my job. Holy mackerel, Jonathan says. That was it. That was all he said. He never mentioned it again. He never swore, which made it even more unusual. Yeah, left that part out. Ed says, for someone here to say something like that, that's almost unheard of. Okay, evidently under a lot of stress. I don't really know what he did. He was forbidden from discussing his work for confidentiality reasons. He never talked about a certain new product he was working on? No, nothing specific. Okay, Hojo's behavior. Do you notice anything unusual about your father before he disappeared? He had been acting kind of strange lately. Maybe things weren't going well at work? Jonathan says, your mother said he would have these breakdowns. Yes. Yes, he did. Now that you mention it, he's normally a calm person. Ed asks, so he definitely was different than usual. Yes, he does have a tendency to worry at times, but nothing like that. Please try to think. Even the littlest thing might make a difference. In what other ways was he different? He would become very pensive and emotional. He was like somebody else altogether. I think he talked to Mom about something, but he never said anything to me. Jonathan says, so Lorraine did know something. Mom didn't tell me anything either. He would kind of watch out for me when he moved about the house. It seemed like he was avoiding me. And asked, why do you say he was avoiding you? I could tell. He's never been good at hiding things like that. Hojo's hobbies. What are your father's hobbies? Music's one of them, I take it, Ed says. Right, I guess that's it. Listening to CDs. That's his only hobby, per se. He doesn't have any friends. So he would spend his days off here? He was almost never home, since he and Mom didn't get along. Their relationship made him into a workaholic. Whenever he was home, he would spend his time listening to music by himself. You saw Dad's collection. Plenty there to keep him busy. It's actually not that much, if that's your only hobby. He doesn't really have any hobbies apart from his music. He's very particular about sound quality. Ed says, I'm not surprised given the equipment here. I'd say his work is his real hobby. I suppose he's your typical Tokugawa employee. Mom probably wasn't satisfied with that kind of husband. Yeah, I had no idea they were so unhappy. Sato. Ed asks, do you know someone called Michael Sato? He works at Tokugawa Pharmaceuticals. Sato. Could be Saito? No, never heard of him. That's a Japanese name, right? Actually, I do remember hearing it now. This is why you repeat asking things. But there are a lot of people here with Japanese names, so it could be common. Oh, dear. Even if I did hear the name before, I never met him. I know for sure I've never met anyone from Dad's work.
ロレインのことは母の仮葬儀は終わりました。母は友人も少なかったし、私だけの寂しい葬儀でした。遺体は難しいみたい。せめてお骨だけでもって思うんですけど。残念ながらビヨンドへの遺体の持ち込みは許可されないでしょう。いや、父が知ったらどんなに悲しむか。遺留品は？
遺留品も無理らしいです。そうですか。お気の毒に。ロレインに君のこと頼むって言われた。そうですか。It's a lot of times he says Lorraine where he says your mom or something instead. You were the one she really loved, Karen says. And then she was so glad when they found you. But I wasn't very nice to her. I felt sorry for Dad and everything. Mom didn't know very many people. I don't see how she could have had any enemies. Who could have done such a thing? Jonathan says the police in OLA are treating it as a terrorist bombing. That's ridiculous. It happened right in front of me. That wasn't some terrorist. It has to be related to your father's disappearance. Her job. I'm a news anchor with BBC. I know. Ed says, we always watch your program at my house. Johnson says, are you off today? I'm taking some time off because of my health. I don't think anyone will realize it's CG they're watching. Okay. We can ask her about her illness in a bit. They're using a CG double of me right now. I don't think anyone will be able to tell the difference. Alright, her illness. Your mother was worried about an illness she said you have, Jonathan says. Would you mind telling me about it? I have aplastic anemia. The hematopoietic stem cells in my bone marrow, the ones that create new blood, have become damaged and I can't produce blood cells properly. I can become anemic or get hemorrhages or be more susceptible to infection. That's why you're so pale, is it? Ed asks. Basically, it's a disease where you become unable to produce new blood. Alright. Its cause. Jonathan asks, how did you get such a serious illness? In my case, it was exposure to cosmic radiation here. I have secondary aplastic anemia. Ed says, unlike home, the surface of beyond gets hit by a good deal of radiation. Dawson says, so the government must offer some form of compensation, right? Ed says, unfortunately, they haven't set up anything official yet, no. Karen says, anti-space groups like the Repatriotists do offer financial support, but I don't want to end up being used by the likes of them. Jonathan says, Repatria... Yeah, they were talking about them on the news. It was your show, actually. Treatment methods. Alright, so this is... same, okay. Treatment methods. Jonathan asks, how do you treat something like that? Someone at your father's work was saying you need a bone marrow transplant? Yeah. Dad talked me into getting immunosuppressive therapy. I could see why he wanted me to try it, but it's not doing much. Apparently, in moderate to severe cases like mine, hormone therapy has no effect either. That bad, huh? Jonathan says. My only remaining option is a bone marrow transplant. Well, maybe Jonathan can do that for her. What does a bone marrow transplant involve? They replace my damaged marrow with marrow from a healthy person. But in order to do the transplant, they need marrow from someone like the same HLA type as me. We still haven't found someone with my type. The transplant costs are enormous, too. The transplant costs, hospitalization fees, immunosuppressants. I don't know where I'm going to get all the money, even if we do find a donor. Jonathan says, you don't look like you're strapped for cash or anything. It's more expensive than you think. Until recently, my priority level on the waiting list was 7, which is for people who can't even pay for the transplant. But last month, I finally got some hope. That's why I'm always checking my phone here. It looks like Dad got me moved up. I'm so grateful for everything he's done. Oh, they're suppressing it with drugs. The thing is, they don't know how long the medication will continue to work. Okay, they're suppressing with drugs until they find a donor. There's additional information there. Okay, Hojo's disappearance. Do you have any theories about what might have happened to your father? Ed asks. He's not the type of person to disappear and not tell anyone. He must have become involved in something. Jonathan says, did he mention anything in particular before he went missing? Actually, yeah, the word Play-Doh, several times. I don't know what he meant by it. We did find that clue on the whiteboard, said Play-Doh, didn't it? Again with this Play-Doh, or Pluto, whatever it is, Jonathan says. I think it's Play-Doh. You can't recall anything else? Says Ed. I was away on assignment at the time. When I got back, Mom had already left for home. If I had been here, I wouldn't have let her do something like that. then this whole game would not exist. I hadn't talked much with Dad lately. Ed asked, what about the 15th of last month? The 15th? You mean the last time anyone saw Dad? Like I said, I was away on assignment. Ed says, there's no sign of anyone having had contact with him after the 15th. Alright, Plato. Jonathan says, so you don't know what he could have meant by this Plato or Pluto thing? Your mother mentioned it too. Wish I knew. There's nowhere with a name like that here. Maybe it's some sort of code name, Karen asks. Alright. We're done with questions, I believe. Let's show her the photo of her and her dad. It's a picture of Mom and Dad. Where'd you get it? Your mother gave it to me on home. I wonder where he could be. A photo of Jonathan and Lorraine.
Karen. この写真。
この写真。
ロレインとの写真だ。処分は君に任せる。
え？どうして？
ロレインはここにいる。このビヨンドに生きている。俺のところじゃない。処分は任せる。
わかった。
Why doesn't he want it?Alright, we don't have that photo anymore. Jonathan says, I'm sorry, but we still need this for the investigation, the other photo. That's okay, I have another copy of it. But I will show it to you repeatedly. the Policenauts photo. Mom used to show me this.I brought it with me to prove who I am, if need be. Other kids had picture books. I had this picture. She never told me why she showed it to me. Here. All right, is that it? Let me go back to this CD, to this one CD. Don't worry, guys, I'm not going to play them all. Play this again. Maybe she'll let us take it. You can have it analyzed.There's no music on it. It's nothing but noise. We got damaged. I can't really seem to do anything with that. Oh, we can go to Hojo's room. Okay.
Hojo-san の部屋を見せてもらえないかな?
Yes, he does.
父の部屋? ああ、書斎なら。
ええ、書斎があるんですか?
ええ。
それじゃあ、書斎を見せてもらえますか。
どうぞ、こっちです。
Maybe we can find something to play that CD on.
ここが父の書斎の日本間です。
Some other machine. As we look at her, we get the same options, right? Yeah. All right, we will look at everything, same as before. Is this adjustable glass? Ed asks. That's shoji glass. It's made to resemble shoji.It's another high-tech glass that lets you control the amount of light that passes through it. Shoji are Japanese screens or doors made out of Japanese paper called washi. It doesn't break as easily as real shoji since it's glass. Does this control the amount of transparency or something? Oh.
日本古来の家紋表です。
Oh.
父はどうしてこんなものを貼っていたんでしょう?家紋の下に大役が書かれているわ。
Jonathan says the Tokugawa logo comes from their family crest, right? It said he had to have a reason for putting this here. It says, let's see what this one says. Dosen Saito, the Nadeshiko, or fringed pink. It says he was the one who originally made this flower into a crest. Ieyasu Tokugawa, the Tokugawa Aoi, if I'm saying that right, or Hollyhock Leaves. It says this became the Matsudaira family crest from their relationship with the Kamo Shrines and was later inherited by Tokugawa. Jonathan says, so we have them to thank for that eyesore of a logo. He really doesn't like the logo. Toshi Maeda, the Kaga Umabachi, or Kaga Plum Blossom. Maeda designed this to stand out from all the other plum crests that were around at the time. Karen says, some people think that he was a descendant of the Sugihara clan. Or, so I heard. Mitsunari Ishida, the Kuyo. It says the Kuyo were heavenly bodies originally used for fortune-telling in ancient India. Jonathan says, this looks somewhat familiar. Yeah, it says, nothing comes to mind. Let's see if it seems familiar. Look at it again. Alright, it's not coming to him. Alright. Nagamase Asai. Oh boy. Ken Hanabishi inside Mitsumori Kiko, or flower diamonds inside three tortoise shells. Hopefully I'm doing alright with the pronunciations. If not, don't blame me. I am not Japanese, or Asian in any way. This is from the Itsu Koshima Shrine in Hiroshima Prefecture. That, to that matter, I don't know if is it Hiroshima or Hiroshima? Hiroshima sounds more like the actual pronunciation that, you know, you'd say it in Japan. It came from the shape of a large boulder in front of a subordinate shrine, Karen says. Or so I heard. She's gonna add that at the end. Hideki Kobayakawa, the crest of the Katori clan, originating from the Katori Shrine in Chiba Prefecture. Karen says the Katori Shrine also uses the Goshichi no Kiri, a Polaunia flower pattern. That's what I heard anyway. Oh boy. Two more. Sun Hojo, the Hojo Uroko, or scales. It says the scales came from a dragon. This isn't my father's family crest. Even though his family name is Hojo, it's not the actual crest he uses. This is speaking in general terms. You know, there's a legend about this crest's origin. One night, the region of Kamakura, Tokumasa Hojo, went to pray for the prosperity of his descendants at Inoshima when a half-human, half-snake woman appeared before him and gave him three scales. He tried to ensure that prosperity by making the scales into his family crest. So these are snake scales? Ed asks. Last one. Takatsuna Sasaki, the Meiyoi. Meiyoi? This belongs to the Omi Genji clan, of which Sasaki was a member. Karen says it's supposed to represent a dying pattern. That's what I heard, anyway. Alright. Okay, his desk. This is an odd desk, Ed says. Where's the chair? It's a zashiki desk, a desk you place on tatami. You sit on the floor with your legs folded under you. That's where Dad drops his things when he gets home from work. What's in these drawers? There was Sumi and Suzuri in them now, before, but they're empty now. There was what? Sumi and Suzuri, ink and inkstones. You use them in calligraphy. Glad to explain that. Dad hadn't been using the drawers lately, so there's nothing in them. What's this on the desk?
その角は?
ID カードじゃないかしら。それは確か予備のコピーカードです。父は用心深い人でしたから。
徳川製薬のガードマンが持っていたものと同じだ。
カレンさん、ちょっとこれ預かってもいいかな。
We can use that.
いいですけど、徳川には内緒ですよ。コピーがあったなんて知れたら大変ですから。
We can use that to get past those other doors. We just have to sneak past the security guard. Maybe, Ed can set up a distraction or something. Karen says, it's a copy, so don't tell anyone at Tokugawa about it, okay? Yes, of course not, Ed says. We promise. I hope that can help somehow. Just wanted to see if she'd say anything else. I'll show her the thing we just got. So what's this? A picture? That's Japanese colored paper, or irigami. Dad wrote one of his famous favorite words on it. What's it say? Ed says. Udu. It means the high road. He used to say one should always walk the high road. Dad told me he owes his success as a scientist to living by this philosophy. What's up here? Books or something? Can't look at that. Ed asks, why is this area of the room higher than the rest? That's the alcove, or the tokonama. It's a special area of the room reserved for placing decorations. Carrying on traditions ain't cheap. Please don't step on it. Who can step on it? That's a hanging scroll, or a kakajiku. Is it a talisman? It's a Japanese custom to decorate the alcove with art and writing. What's written on it? My doctrine is that of an all-pervading unity. Dad says it's part of the Analects of Confucius.
それはロレイン。
母さんの仏壇。
Or what?
まだホームから遺体が届いてませんけど。
遺体をビヨンドへ入れるには手続きが非常に難しいんだ。
母さんも日系人だから仏壇に。
ロレインが死んだのは俺の責任だ。彼女は助けを求めてきた。俺を頼って。しかし俺は彼女を追い返した。
You told her you think about it.
でも母さんは幸福だったはずです。あなたに会えて、それが何よりもの慰め。
This is actually the Hojo family altar. I never imagined I'd need to use it for this so soon. Oh wait, I missed something. No, I'm ridiculous, guys. Shall we go now, Jonathan? Oh, I can't go back to the study. We've learned quite a lot here. Should we head off now? He won't let us go back. I want to look at the plant, but I'm sure it's not going to say anything much different from the plant in this room. So, next episode we'll leave. Unless something unexpected happens, we'll be going to the hospital next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.